name's Mika Epstein. Most people know me as Ipstinum. I work for Dreamcoast as a WordPress and Dreampress developer, playing with a full stack. The cloud I used for this experience was Dream Objects, but it happens on Amazon S3 too. And yes, all over the place. The site that runs the code was built on Dreampress, and Dreamhost is kind enough to support me not just coming to events like this, but to run that site on Dreampress as a bit of our canary and use it to test and explore and figure out how can we make hosting better for everyone, but also how to make WordPress better for everyone, no matter where they host. Thank you, and we've got 2 minutes for questions. Excellent. Yes?
I love your presentation, and I'm just going to do it in that geeky way, and then on another level where is it possible to take the SVGs and turn them into a font set?
Is it possible to take the SVGs and turn them into a font set? Yes, it is, but when you take an SVG set and turn it into a font set, you have to load the entire font set, or portions of it, on every single page, whether or not you use the image. And our thought was that, well, let's just load the images as we need them instead of the whole font size. For example, we used Font Awesome at first, and you know, loading it, we had it locally installed, not at the remote for some reason. And the size of the page is a little bit larger, and we were trying to keep page size down to keep page speed, you know, down. But it was definitely a viable option. We did experiment with it in the very early stages before we said, no, the SVGs are a little bit better. Plus, it's a lot easier to just add a new image than it is to go in and rebuild the font stack.
I got you. I was curious about the hot part.
I can show you the back if you go back there if you'd like.
I was just kind of curious how SVGs ended up being the same pulled on the server when they were actually supposed to be lighter than air, you know?
The SVG, so why is the SVG the slow on the server when they're supposed to be lighter than air? They are actually, when it's local, they're incredibly faster than anything else, but it was just those multiple calls every time I went to the server.
So just to continue with that line, it sounded like at first like the problem was that they weren't local or that it had something to do with the CDN, but the problem was the remote get. Is that it? So you could, for example, if you just keep them local but invoke a CDN that it just sort of chooses its own files like Cloudflare or something, you probably wouldn't experience the same slowness as what you described. Is that true to say?
I experienced the same kind of slowness with a Cloudflare-type CDN. Cloudflare is more of a proxy CDN than a true CDN. So when I talk about a CDN, what I really mean is like using the Akami CDN or something where you actually have the files loaded on another server and you call them locally. Photon does a very good job of this, where you think that the images are on your server, but they're really duplicated to a Photon server. If you use Jetpack, that's Photon is their, they call it something else now. It actually copies the images out to their servers and dynamically replaces the content on your site so that it's calling remotely instead of locally. That's the kind of CDN that I'm talking about. There is another kind of CDN, like Cloudflare. Security has one. Encapsula has one, and those are CDNs that act as a proxy where there are a wall between you and your visitor. And with those, they copy your whole site, so they would, in fact, copy the SVGs to their local.
For the first kind of CDN that you mentioned, which is the one I mean, if you looked at your source, you would see different URLs for those images pointing to the CDN server instead of your server, right? That's what you're talking about, where
you're
replacing the code. And that would have been slow for you as well?
Yes, even having it done that way, having it be where the file, the URLs were placed and it was calling it remotely, those were still slow to call. Because the only way to get those, I say that, and I hesitate because there's actually code that I'm working on myself to try to resolve this in other ways, which is what if I dynamically change them, and that was the whole JavaScript journey. The only way to tell WordPress and PHP where the images are is to literally tell it, here are where your images are, you need to get them. And because I had to tell it, go to the cloud and get them so that you could generate things in the PHP at some point, because otherwise it's just not which is what would be involved in making it faster. But also, again, those are true images. And remote loading true images is always easier because you're just going to swap out the image source location. And if that's all I was doing, CDN's no problem. Doesn't matter if they're SVGs. Problem is that SVGs don't act like images, and if you use image tags, you restrict what you can do with them. So that was an option, but it would make my site lousy and I didn't like that. Does anyone else have any questions?
If anybody else does, I have one other question. As you were talking through the tools that you were using to figure out what might be slowing down your site, you mentioned the database tools. But one thing that a lot of times I've experienced slow sites, and I don't really understand how to use query monitor that well, but I used it and I see that there really aren't too many slow queries. So my next thought is that it could be the server itself, maybe something with PHP running slowly, maybe not enough memory, things like that. And if you're using a server that you don't have full control of, you can't find out those things easily. And I'm wondering, for example, I just helped one of my clients load a site onto a specific host whose name I won't mention, and we found that the site took, it was a WooCommerce site, and it was taking 20 to 30 seconds to load pages sometimes, and it was a brand new VPS, so we couldn't believe that it would have been that server's fault. But then we tried another hosting company, and then the site loaded in 3 seconds, so we clearly determined that it was a factor of that particular first host that we chose. But I don't know how I could have, what tools could I have maybe used to figure out that side of it other than just, you know, slow bandwidth or slow database?
So the question for those watching on video is, query monitor is great if you're trying to find any HTTP calls and database calls and things like that, but how do you debug things that might be caused by the PHP implementation on the server? Especially if you don't have access to the server with command line, that's really hard. When you said WooCommerce, though, I immediately thought, oh, well, probably the issue is going to be in the fact that the way that WooCommerce interacts with PHP is different than any other plugins, most other plugins. And that's because it's a big beast of a plugin. It does a lot of amazing, wonderful things. Debugging it is a nightmare because it doesn't like all versions of PHP. The thing that I always start with when I'm trying to debug PHP is figure out what version I'm on. I'm fairly certain that WooCommerce itself has you can check out a PHP info page within the WooCommerce dashboard to just get an idea of what sort of PHP options have been selected and installed. There isn't a great plugin that lets you go in and say, aha, these PHP queries are slow. That said, Query Monitor actually is going to tell you some of those things, but reading it can be very difficult. Less difficult today than it was a week ago, but understanding what each line means and what each call means. You say, well, here are my database queries, here are these queries. It'll tell you things like this PHP function took a long time to run. But that doesn't really help you understand why is that specific PHP function slow. It just tells you that it is. And with WooCommerce being so big, it is really hard to say, well, okay, that's a function. Great. Cool. What do I do now? Which is what I spend a lot of time doing for people who host on DreamPress. Sometimes they have those problems, and we go through and we try to help them figure it out. In the case of WooCommerce, it is very rarely WooCommerce itself that isn't playing well with your version of PHP, but it's going to be one of your plugins or add-ons for WooCommerce. They are not all created people, not even the ones you buy from the WooCommerce store. The reason for that is, unless they're written by automatic loads WooCommerce, odds are they haven't gone through quite as rigorous testing on multiple environments, which is why you see such a big difference between host A and host B. And a lot of that comes down to hosts having different, what's the word I'm looking for?
Yeah.
Different beliefs in what PHP security means. Some hosts believe that the best PHP security is to lock people out of everything. And some people believe that the best PHP security is to make PHP itself relatively secure. Good luck, have a nice day. Both of these are valid concepts. If you've made PHP itself secure, yeah, you technically don't have to worry about what your customers and clients are doing. On the other hand, if you prevent them from doing certain things that could possibly hurt them, you've made them safer, but you just made debugging a real nightmare. The best thing that I like to do when I see problems like that is I spin up a local box, not even on a separate host. I just try to figure out how can I reproduce the problem. And so what I'll do is I'll go to that PHP info page in WooCommerce, have that hard stuff, and debugging PHP problems is just going to remain hard stuff. I would strongly advise you keep debug bar on. There are a few debug bar add-ons that do purport to help with finding those PHP problems. A friend of mine, Jenny, wrote a few of them, and I'm blanking on their names, but if you just look up debug bar add-ons, there are some that are good for like helping you with your permalink problems, or if you're trying to do redirects and like make custom endpoints and stuff, and things that will help you with the JSON API, which I'm just so much in love with REST API right now, it's crazy. But those things can help you. But the biggest problem you're going to have with debugging WooCommerce is that the trick to being able to debug all this successfully was that I knew what my site was doing. Knowing what WooCommerce is doing requires being almost a WooCommerce expert at this point for the code, not just for the product. And that is not something I envy you.
Thanks.
All right, does anyone else have a question? Yes?
Relating back to the request in the CDN, was it, you didn't say specifically, was it using just HTTP1 or was it an option to do try to 2.0?
So was it an option to use HTTP1, or HTTP2, excuse me, instead of HTTP1 for the request? It was not, because the cloud services, well, it was on Amazon, and it didn't seem to make too much of a difference. It sped up that it could do multiple calls at once, but because PHP is a top-down sort of thing, and I was saying, you know, loop through all of my tags, and for each tag, if it has an icon, show the icon. It was difficult to speed that up because PHP doesn't really understand simultaneous calls quite the same way that we would like it to. So sadly, HTTP2 didn't really speed it up, and it was only available on one of the servers I tested on when I was trying to reproduce the problem. Which sucked. You thought it would have helped. I mean, there are a lot